All right, thanks, Kaylee. You know, the Sertoma Chili Cook-Off is Saturday, mm-hmm. and Jeff White with Aaron Saxon Associates is here with us, and you are cooking up something I've never seen before in my life.
Well, I wanted to show people how to use leftover chili. We always have leftover chili. After a day or two, you get tired of eating it the normal way, right?
Right. Yeah.
So I'm going to make empanadas, and it's a really simple recipe. You basically take some empanada shells, which I have here.
Okay.
Yep.
Where can you get something like that?
You can get them here locally on at the Latino Market on St. Louis Street.
Uh-huh.
I encourage everyone to go out there. It's like going back to a different country.
That's
cool. Is it just a flour tortilla?
You can make them, I'm sure.
Yeah.
I bought them. And basically what you do is you take some chili, put it in the middle, along with some cheese, whatever filling you want to put in it.
Uh-huh. Oh, you had me cheese and onions.
Yeah, exactly. I tend to fill them too much. These you don't want to.
Yeah, you don't want to do too much with it.
Yeah.
as far as that goes. And you just take a fork and you press down and pull all the way around.
Oh, that is so easy.
That's awesome.
Until you get something like this.
Okay.
And you just drop it in your fryer.
Okay, now what kind of fancy fryer is this?
Okay, so this is my Miller Lite Discada cooker or disco cooker. By the way, Miller Lite's 38-year sponsor of the Chili Cook-Off, the longest
yes.
one running.
Yeah.
Very cool.
And basically it was developed, well, not developed, they made them out of a plow disc in the old days. So this is a fancier version. You can fry in the middle, you can saute in the middle, pull your different meats up on the side, they drain back in, your onions, your peppers, you make street tacos in this. Right now I'm using it as a fryer. As you can see, you've got some up here that have drained off.
Yeah, that's and a perfect design.
Yeah, it really is very efficient.
Yeah.
So,
how long has it been around?
I have no idea. I actually just got, I bought this about 6 months ago.
Mm-hmm.
I've been watching YouTube videos on different kinds of cuisine, Asian food, Mexican food, and this is something that I latched onto. So simple as that.
I love how you do it,
long.
And the oil drips back down so you're not wasting
yeah.
oil, and
exactly.
you get the oil off the
that
food.
Exactly.
That is amazing. So are we yes. going to get to try one?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Now, do
go
you
ahead.
Want this?
What would you like?
What do you want?
You can use a bowl. Sure. I actually was going to put one in here and make
oh, yes,
it
pretty.
Oh,
yes, whatever
you want to do.
Oh,
that's
this?
Gorgeous.
I got to get a photo
yeah,
of this then.
And I hope they taste good.
Oh, I'm sure
oh,
it will.
Oh, my goodness. Look at that. That is beautiful.
That's gorgeous.
Oh, my gosh.
It's got everything in it that I love.
I got to go to this angle, though.
Food eats first. Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Now, if I was at home, you know what I'd be doing with this. Plop it on salsa and sour cream.
Yes, absolutely.
Exactly. And now this is smoked cheese that I smoked on my smoker. I'm kind of a foodie guy.
Wait, I'm going to taste it.
Let me see.
I just loved it.
Super.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow. That's amazing.
Yeah.
I've never had smoked cheese.
I haven't
you never
either.
Have? Really?
No.
Wow.
That's
so
really
that adds it up, you know, kicks it up a little bit. Have fun with your food, you know.
Tell you to dig in there.
Yeah. Are these going to be hot still?
Be careful on some yeah. of these. Maybe the one I just took
okay.
out will be.
Oh, yeah. You see that steam right coming uh-huh. out? Okay. You know what? I'm going to. Can I take this knife and cut
absolutely.
Into it?
Oh, yeah. Here. Cut it right in the middle.
Okay.
I can already tell you.
Oh, yeah.
That's my new favorite way to eat chili.
Oh, wow. Yeah, you're right. And we do like our leftover chili. But then after a day or two, you want to do something different.
Yeah, make chili a little more unhealthy, right?
Uh-huh.
Right? I mean, if you have to put it that way. Yeah.
That is messy and delicious.
It's messy and delicious.
Delicious. That's right.
Mm. Wow.
Oh,
I think you just created a new fad.
That's spicy.
I put a little heat in there. Yeah.
Yeah.
I wouldn't turn that into the judges. It's a little bit too hot.
Wow.
I put jalapeno powder in.
Jalapeno powder?
And some cayenne pepper in there.
So
me,
I like anything spicy. The spicier, the better.
Mm-hmm.
That's my kind of chili. Would you call that 4-alarm chili?
Yeah.
Or 3.5-alarm?
Wow, you should have put a warning on that one.
My daughter won't eat it. I know that.
Oh, really? How old's your daughter?
She's 12.
Well, luckily, yeah. there's just one
little
scoop.
She doesn't like spicy stuff.
There's just one little scoop in there.
I also love that cheese so much. It's so delicious.
You know what? I'm gonna share a secret with you. I bought that at Aldi for $2.
Did you really?
I put it on my smoker, cold smoked it. Now it's like a $10 cheese. So you can do stuff like that, too.
That's fantastic. And you know what? Always more cheese makes it better.
Yes. Now, what are you guys going to be making at the Chili Cook-Off?
Mm-hmm. We're just going to go with this chili. You know what? The World Food Championships is offering a spot to go for the winner this year. So Whoever wins gets to go to Dallas, Texas, and cook and represent Springfield, Missouri in the World Food Championships.
Wow.
Had a chance to win over $100,000. So.
That's wonderful.
So I hope you're, I hope you're ready for your A game, for your chili.
We're going to try. We're going to try. You know, Aaron likes to win.
Yeah, I know.
Absolutely.
He's a good dancer, too.
He is.
He's a good dancer. I haven't seen him dance.
A lot of things. You didn't see him dance?
No, I didn't see him.
In the Super Bowl commercial?
No.
The only thing in the Super Bowl worth watching was the commercials, and his commercial was hilarious.
It was good. Did you bring a speaker over here? What is that over there?
I did, but I didn't bring my phone, so.
Oh, man.
All right, then.
Hey, wait, wait. Since we were, you know, cooking on a disco, and these things are called discos, I don't need to hold that up. You can see that it says discos.
Oh, they're called discos.
What are we holding up? Oh, right.
10 discos. These are the Aaron Sachs disco empanadas.
I love it.
In reference to his dancing at the Super Bowl.
That's fantastic.
He's got moves.
Travis
and
Kelsey.
He brought some music, but he doesn't have his phone.
Yeah, BG's,
nothing's better than Bee Gees for discoing.
You know, it would be perfect right now.
Mm-hmm. I really want to go get these because I never attempted to make an empanada, but I knew growing up in I grew up in Dallas. I mean, these were, you know, Mexican food, Tex-Mex was the go-to food. And put chili in something like this.
You know, I think you could probably do an egg roll like this, too, but I didn't do
it. I bet you could. Yeah, I bet you could. I've made egg rolls, you know, from scratch, and they are delicious.
Great
you
finger food for tailgating and football, you know, things like that.
So. Now, are you the head chef for the chili cook-off Saturday?
I'm the head cook for Aaron Sachs. I'm in charge of it.
So did you win last year?
We won our division.
Oh, that's good.
But we didn't know where we placed after that.
Yeah.
So let me ask you the chili question. That is the question that divides most people. Beans or no beans?
We were talking about this yesterday. You know, the people that win in competitions, the traditional chili, the Texas-style chili or the Tex-Mex style, doesn't use beans.
Right.
But our judges aren't from there, so we're going to go with beans. So we think we're cooking for the judges and not really to be traditional. So
the original Tex-Mex is without beans?
Right. It never hurts to butter up the judges. But yeah, a lot of people don't like the beans in it, but my mom, growing up, would always put beans in it.
Yeah, we always
did. So that's
did.
What we were used to in Texas. But I think it's individual style, or if you're thinking you're authentic, you know, with the chili.
Right,
but it depends.
I think if you keep it basic and in the realm of what they're used to eating, I think the exotic stuff just doesn't really go.
Yeah.
We were out one time at the World Food Championships, and I went with the... out from Rockin' Ribs, but a potato salad contest, and we ended up winning that. And at any rate, a lot of the people were making crazy mango potato salads and weird things like this. And
we've learned this on cook-offs. We like to stay, if you stay traditional, the judges are happier.
Exactly.
Yeah, keep it simple.
So, you know, make it flavorful, though. Use good ingredients and things. Think it out, practice.
Yeah.
So we've done that.
So this is the chili you're cooking this year?
This is not, because it's too hot.
It's too spicy.
And again, you're going to alienate some of your audience with too much spice.
Yeah, and we don't really actually, we have a recipe, and... we'll probably follow it, but we may throw in some ingredients. We're messing around with some bacon, I think.
We do that all the time.
We do that, too. Yeah, we mix
We can never be settled with just a recipe. We've got to add our own spin.
Yeah, yeah.
Jeff, it's so good to see you. You'll be there Saturday at the chili cook-off.
At the Aaron Sachs booth. You can't miss it. We have three spots.
Will Aaron be there disco dancing?
Aaron will be there. I don't know.
I'm going to come pay him to disco dance then.
Well, bring the BG.
Come by and come by and we'll entice him to that. Yeah, we'll have music then.
Perfect.
That'd be great.
Thank you so much.
All
right, thank
good
you guys.
To see you.
All right, we'll be back to wrap things up in just a minute.
Can I have more?
Yes,
absolutely.
Have more.
Oh, I was going to make more. I've got enough to make 20.
Oh my gosh, you do?
So I'm going to take him in the studio when I get done.
Oh, perfect.
Done.
Thank you.